What'd you say, Petey? What? I don't know about that, Peter. That sounds a little weird. You sure? Hey, what's up, Plane Crash Survivors? This is KG48, and welcome back to my Let's Play of the Forest. This is episode 38. Petey, we'll talk later. Yeah, welcome back to the forest, guys. Gonna be doing some, video here. I was totally not talking to that head. We're going to be finishing up this build, kind of trying to get some stuff done here. I got a lot of people giving me crap for not finishing builds, so I think this might be a good time to maybe, you know, finish a build. That might be pretty cool. A lot of you guys like the idea of building at the boat next season. I haven't made up my mind completely, but I'm kind of leaning towards the boat. Problem with the boat is there's not a ton of trees in the area. It's going to be a very hard, you know, let's play to pull off, as far as getting logs and stuff. But, you know, we'll see. I got some ideas. I'm not really sure. I haven't made up my mind yet. If we don't build the boat, please don't be disappointed. I just kind of throwing out the ideas out there to get a feeling on what people want. Got anybody out here? Nope. Close the door then. You're letting the heat out. That doesn't make any sense because we're not. No, never mind. Anyway, oh boy, do I even care about this many logs? Can I put them on here? Yeah, I can put one on there, two on there, and then we'll just leave that one alone. We're gonna have to go cut down some trees, guys. We haven't cut down some trees in a while. We haven't been using logs. It's been a lot of rocks. But this is definitely gonna use our logs, and we're gonna have to go out there and cut down some trees. Pretty scary out there with the cannibals. I don't know if I want to be dealing with it, but it is what it is. We gotta do what we gotta do. Stupid rabbit. I hate you. I hate you! Oh, boy. So, yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do here. We're gonna finish up this build, and I'm gonna decide about this Let's Play. I think it might be time to start anew. We'll see. We'll see. We definitely got a few more videos here because we've got at least a couple more videos. As a matter of fact, I'm going to stop talking about it. We're just going to build because I love this build. I really, really love this build so much. This is like by far my favorite build. I'm either next season going to build in a field or with a lot of trees around me, or I'm going to build out into that boat. Not really sure which I want to do. Boat shouldn't be that bad. Yeah, maybe I'll build that to the boat. It could be pretty cool. I think I'm going to build that to the boat. The major reason I don't want to build that to the boat is because it's going to take a lot of logs and a lot of time. But you know what? I don't stream this game enough, so whatever. I could just stream my single player, right? How many of you watch my streams? How many of you go to my streams? I've got a couple people come to my streams and ask me if I'm going to stream the forest. And yeah, I mean, that's a good idea, actually. So that way I could do a lot of the busy work off camera and just do it on stream. And for those of you who don't know, who don't go to my streams, I have another YouTube account called CageCast Live. CageCast Live, where I record, you know, I basically take my streams and I put them up on YouTube on that account. So, you know, just because I'm streaming the forest and maybe you can't make it to streams, you don't have time, maybe I just stream at a bad time for you, I don't know. But with CageCast Live, you could go check it out whenever you want to. So, yeah, you know what? Again, no promises, but I'm leaning towards the boat build. I'm leaning towards the boat build. I think that'd be pretty cool. What I want to do is I want to build a... Yeah, you know, I kind of want to build a structure around it, but not over it like I did last episode. I kind of want to build one kind of around it, but like right over the water, like barely over the water. And then that way I can get in the boat without having to cut a hole in the top of the, you know, the foundation I built. Could be pretty cool. And then we take it from there. Once I can get in the boat, I could save and sleep there. And I got the boat as a, you know, a getaway. It'd be pretty sweet. You know what? I'm looking at 80%. I'm going to build it the boat. I'm pretty sure I'm going to build it the boat. The only thing I don't like about that area is it's pretty heavily traveled by the you-know-whats, the big C. Big bad cannibals, but whatevs. Yeah, where's there a lot of trees? I'd say right about here. We're gonna cut down the trees going this way, which means we want to put the log sleds out here. But I'm not doing anything until this build, until I feel like this build is finished. of, you know, sticks. We got a lot of work to do, actually. All right. Got to grab some of these and go out there. Let's get in position. Hey, guys. Doing a little post-commentary here. I was actually planning on doing this time-lapse to music. I was going to go on YouTube. As a matter of fact, I think after this time-lapse, I actually talk about it. But I decided against it. I was going to go to YouTube and actually take some of their supposed royalty-free music off the site. But I've actually done some research into it, and it seems like some people have actually had, they've taken YouTube's royalty-free music and put it in their videos and still gotten hit with matched third-party content. So I said, you know what? I want music out of my videos. Let's just do some post-commentary. I'm sure you guys would at least, you know, wouldn't hate to hear my voice over the music. So we're just chopping down some trees here. I'm going to, trying to do this build. I mean, I need a lot of logs for this build, man. Like it's ridiculous. Like, and I still need to put a roof on this thing. And oh, hold on, got attacked. There's a lot of these guys coming. By the way, I remember this. Yeah, basically, I kind of like wait for them to attack one at a time, and then I take them out. It seems to work okay. See, they do attack one at a time, like ninjas. Like when like there's one person trying to defend themselves against like 10 ninjas, the ninjas always come in one at a time, and that's exactly what these cannibals do. I was looking for some places to throw some TNT, but the trees are just simply not close enough together in here. So I was like, yeah, screw it. I'll just cut them down. You know what? I could use the sap anyway. You actually need quite a bit of sap in the game now. You pretty much need it to repair everything. So you're kind of better off cutting down trees now, even more so than using the dynamite. And it doesn't take that long, honestly. Using dynamite probably isn't that much faster. It's definitely faster, but I don't know about, you know, how much faster. So, yep, there we go. Logs for days, people. Love it. Love it. Anyway, let me know what you think. Do you like to see the music more, or do you want to see more of this post-commentary stuff? Just let me know in the comments. Oh, what was that? Oh, must have been me. All right, guys, I'm back. I actually am planning to do an impromptu, what do you call it? Lumber lapse. I haven't done time lapses in quite a while because I've been getting a little worried about copyright issues. I mentioned this on a 7 Days to Die video. Wow, that's loud. I don't think I mentioned it here though. So just in case you don't know what's going on, basically, I went to look up one of the songs that I use in one of my 7 Days to Die time lapse music, and I get it from a site called Royalty Free Music by a guy named Kevin McLeod. And I've been using it for years, and I'm probably being over-concerned about this, to be perfectly honest. But I'm kind of nervous, because what happened was I went to look for this one song, and he actually sold it. And he sold it to somebody. Now, I think he still owns some of the rights, because I had not gotten hit with copyright issues for that. Because, you know, if the person who owns that music now could, you know, theoretically lay a claim on any YouTube music that gets used. So I go to copyright music because, you know, I want to put up my YouTube videos with music, but I don't want to have to worry about, you know, them being unmonetized. And a lot of some of my videos are evergreen. They get watched over and over and over, like, for a while. Like, so I don't want to lose the monetization for that stuff, because I'm trying to do this, you know, kind of like a full-time job, you know? So it's kind of important to me that music be safe. And I was really scared because I saw Kevin McLeod sold that song, and I don't know what that means. It made me very nervous, so I swore off music. I'm going to go back on that, because someone actually said in the comments, and someone else mentioned it on Twitter, and I heard about it somewhere else. Like, they said, why don't you just use YouTube's copyright-free music? And you know what? I trust Kevin McLeod. I really do. And I trust his music. I've never had any issues with it. But I trust YouTube even more. And as a matter of fact, going into the YouTube library on stuff that... Oh, by the way, I looked up the YouTube... what YouTube said about their copyright-free music. They said that copyright music will be free forever. And that's what I wanted to see. I don't want to know if it's free now. You know, if you sell it in 2 years down the road, and then I get a copyright claim on my video, I'm going to be pissed, you know? And that kind of sucks. And I'm pretty sure Kevin McLeod music is free forever. When he sells it, there's probably some stipulation in there that they can't lay copyright claims on it, because, like I said, he sold a song, so somebody else owns it, and they're under no obligation to leave it copyright free. They could say, no, forget that, man, I'm gonna start laying claims on YouTube videos. And it's never happened to a royalty free song before. As a matter of fact, royalty free music itself would collapse if that ever happened, because royalty free music runs on the fact that It's trusted. And I've never, ever heard anyone ever say royalty-free music is not 100%. So I think when Kevin MacLeod sells a song, maybe he retains the rights in some way. Maybe he sells the ability for them to use the song, but he still retains the rights. I'm not really sure. But the fact of the matter is someone did buy that song and they did not lay copyright claims on me, which leads me to believe even royalty-free music songs are probably good forever. As a matter of fact, when I went and looked at YouTube's site with their music, Kevin MacLeod actually has music on the YouTube site. So I think I'm pretty good. What I'm trying to say is, long story short, the time lapses are coming back. The lumber lapses, the mine lapses, the crafting lapses, whatever you want to call them, they're coming back. And I'm really happy about that because I kind of miss them. Yeah, I also need a new outro. Damn it. Now, the other thing I have to worry about my stuff is that music on the outro. I think I got that from Royalty Free Music as well, so it's probably okay. But I'd like to get a new outro because, man, it's about freaking time. A lot of people ask me, Cage, why don't you get a new outro? Well, the problem is I don't have time to make it. I made my last outro. Now I don't mind commissioning people to do work for me. As a matter of fact, that's probably going to be the way I'm going to go. But I've commissioned one person to do work for me once. All right, it cost me a few hundred dollars, and you know, I wasn't really happy with it. Hold on. All right, we're going to go take care of these punk asses. All right. I think you can only do one thing at arrows now at a time, by the way. Hello. Hold up. I'll be with you in a second. Goodbye. That was a headshot, by the way. Oh, you son of a bitch. Eat it, punk. How do you like them apples? You running away? You better run away. Smart move. That's the smartest guy in the crew, that's for sure. Okay. Anyway, I'd commission it. It was all right. It was kind of really expensive, though. I've had other people offer to commission me YouTube stuff. We're talking, like, hundreds and hundreds of dollars, like $500 worth of work. And I'm like, you know what, man? I don't know about that, you know? So it got a little expensive, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Now, my buddy Fat Planet has someone in the stream team that we're a part of that does that kind of work. God damn it. That does that kind of work. So I'm going to get in touch with them and see if I can get them to do my stuff for me at a reasonable price. Not that I'm cheap, but, you know, man, it's like pretty expensive, dude. So, yeah, I'm going to get someone to make me a new outro for sure. I like my intro. One of the problems I had with the person who I was working with was, like, they wanted to make me an intro, and they made me an intro, and it was a really nice intro, but the problem was way too long, and we couldn't get them to cut it down. Like, I couldn't cut it down myself. I got it down to about 9 seconds. 9 seconds is too long for an intro, in my opinion. An intro should be no longer than 5 seconds. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna have to look for some work. I need a new outro for sure. Someone actually got in touch with me on my email and said, I'll make you an outro. Like, it's been a couple weeks, so you know, we'll see what they come up with. But if they come up with something good, that'd be great. And I won't have to worry about it, but we'll see. I'm looking for a way. I know someone who has a outro that is a really good idea. It's an outro that says, you know, their name and like whatever. And what it is just a big page of their Patreon supporters. And I thought that'd be pretty cool for an outro thing. You know, every month I go through and put my Patreon supporters on there. Could be a nice way to, you know, thank people for their generous financial support. It's beautiful. I try not to talk about Patreon too much on YouTube because I feel that YouTubers get pissed off when they hear Patreon. Because they think, like, we're all making PewDiePie money, and we're not. But Patreon's just for people who want to go that extra mile. It's not really... It's not needed. It's not... It's not a necessity. It's if you want to. It's not a big deal. As a matter of fact, today, you know what Patreon's for? Today, I had someone send me a message on, I had someone leave a comment on one of my videos, and they said, yeah, I mean, how is the monetization thing hitting you, the demonetization thing? Because any of you guys that don't know, there's something on YouTube going around right now where YouTube's, like, demonetizing videos that aren't, quote-unquote, ad-friendly. I'm not going to get into it, but, yeah, it's kind of an issue. It has not happened to me yet, but someone sent me a message or sent on a comment, you know, has that hit you? Have you been getting demonetized? Because if you are, let me know, and I'll go support you on Patreon. And I was like, oh, my God, you know, like, that's, like... That warms my heart, man. That kind of stuff just... I don't even know what to say. Like, I have no words. I have no words. And I said, you know what? It's fine. I've not been getting with monetization. But if that person is watching this video, it means the world to me. That kind of stuff is just... I mean, you're all friggin' awesome. I mean, anyone who watches, like... I know I get some kids, you know, some 13, 14, 15-year-olds who are like, yeah, Cage, I'd like to help you, give you money, but I can't. I'm a kid. I don't have a job. And I can just tell... Ooh, that doesn't sound good. Let's get to the bone zone. We haven't used the bone zone in a while. Anyway, I could tell, like, the kid was just, like, kind of upset about it. And I was like, you know what, guys, man? Like, you know what you do for me? You watch and you thumb up and you comment. That is the biggest support you could ever give me. And anything you want to do over that is, it's all gravy. And I appreciate it. Believe me, it goes a long way. But don't feel bad if you can't give any kind of financial support. It's God, it's perfectly fine. Like, hold on a sec. Dried. Wait, how do I eat it? There we go. Let's go put this stuff in the drying rack, actually. Doesn't even sound like they're following me. But anyway, like I'm saying, that extra financial support's only for people who want to do it. It's not necessary. And do not even begin to feel bad if you can't do it. I mean, that just broke my heart. When I see people saying that, oh, I can't do it, I'm sorry. And I'm just like, no. You guys have got the whole donation thing all wrong. That is not what it's about. I just want you guys to sit back, pop a soda or a beer, depending on your age, and just put on a playlist and just watch my videos. That's all I want. I want you to be entertained and have a good time. Some of them you can't watch with your family. I'm trying to clean it up, but, you know, some you can. But yeah, I mean, that's what I want. I just want you guys to have a good time. Let's go ahead and sleep through the night. And then I will go out there and finish cutting down some trees. Should we save? Yeah, let's save. Always save when you can. Good night. Probably pretty late to be going to bed, but that's okay. If there's any cannibals out there, I'm gonna cut them. I'm gonna cut them good. Anybody out here? Okay. Don't come back. Don't come back now, you hear? Alright, let's start getting some of these log sleds inside, shall we? And every time I come out here, I keep thinking I'm hearing things, you know? It's kind of freaky. Like, I'm like, oh, did I hear something? Did I hear that? And then I'm like, when I turn my back on that forest, I'm just like, ooh. You know, I don't like it, man. It just makes me scared. Got some things I gotta do up there. Yeah, a little post up there. Alright, is that the last one that has logs in it? I think it is. Yeah, alright, let's get inside. Got a couple things I want to do. First thing I'm going to do is, I've been meaning to make a water skin this whole time. So there we go, we got a nice water skin. Let's go ahead and fill it up. By the way, if I drink this water, it'll make me sick, but if I drink it out of a water skin, I think it's okay. I think moving water from a waterfall is kind of safe to drink for the most part. So, all right, let's go ahead and do this. That went in this, didn't it? Oh, empty. Oh, there we go, cool. So can I drink out of this? Yes, I can. Did I get sick? No, I didn't. Very good, combined with what? Can't combine that with anything. I can't drink it all. Alright, whatever. That's cool. So you get 3 drinks out of that, by the way, it looks like. Nope. I got sick. Sick as fuck, dude. Is that because I drank too much, or is that because I drank this water at all? Curious. That's because I drank too much, right? I don't know. Shoot. Alright, well, I'll have to keep an eye on that. I'm sure you guys will let me know in the comments. Because technically that water is no good. If I drink out of that water, I'm supposed to get sick. Let's take a look at our guy. Let's see what's going on with him. Sick. Find some aloe or get some rest. Alright. Strength. Okay, so strength is going down because we're sick. Alright, so let's go ahead and eat some aloe. Game Edge would be proud. Alright, now we're good. What's this? Means my weight's going up? Okay. I guess, like in real life, your weight going up is usually never a good thing. But in this game, I think your weight going up is probably a good thing in this situation. Alright. I want to do something over here. Let's go upstairs really quickly. Because I don't like the way this looks. This part right here, I don't like the way this looks from the outside. So I think what we're going to do is, I'm going to try and put a pole in there. This is going to be very difficult, by the way. I don't think you can do it with this. Let's see, can I? Probably not. Yeah. So you got to move this around. They should let us put single poles in the game. Alright, well, I'm not licked yet. Let's try it with the stairs. Is there a way to do it with the stairs? Maybe. Possibly. Let me see. Hold on. I'm not licked yet. Let's see what we can do. I know there's a way to do this. I just don't know how. Right in the middle. Right? But then there's a second part, though. See, I can't get that up. Nah. That's not gonna work. I don't know how to get a pole in there. I'm sure there's a way, I just don't know. Damn it. It's gonna bother me. Alright, well, I'll leave it up to the experts. I'll wait until Game Edge figures out a way to do it. I'd really like to have a pole going up there. I know there's a way to do it with the stairs. I just don't know how. Right here. Right there. See, I can't get the stairs above the wood either. Which means it's going to look like shit. So you want to do it like that. But then the stairs are in the way. That doesn't look right. I don't know. Whatever. Let's not worry about it. This out so we don't accidentally drink that water. Let's go ahead and make some more fire arrows. I love the fire arrows, by the way. They're freaking sick. Can I make twin berry poison arrows? Oh! Poison arrows! Yee! Why do I sound like an idiot? I don't know. I'm excited. I want to poison some punk-ass cannibals. What? I'm the bad guy now? I'm not the bad guy. Not in this world. On multiplayer, I'm the bad guy. We are the bad guys in multiplayer. We crash a ship. Or a ship, yeah, right? We crash a plane. Probably our fault. And then we proceed to kill every cannibal we find and their children and their whole family and tribe and take over and build houses in their bases and just, you know, be totally awful, awful human beings. I will agree with that. But on single player, I don't think so. I'm minding my own business. The only thing you could say that kind of makes me a dick is I don't give a crap about Timmy. Timmy can rot in hell. The only way I'm going to care about Timmy is if he's going to help me chop down trees once I get him. So, alright guys, we are coming up to the end of this video. As a matter of fact, there's my timer. Alright, so we're going to call this one here. That's going to be it for episode 38. We'll see you next time for episode 39. Till then, take it easy.